Have you ever had an inventory full of random junk you have no intention of using? Well, I have exactly the device for you. This right here is the garbage can I'll be showing you how to build today. It works perfectly, and this is all the redstone for it. This is literally all you need. There's nothing hidden behind the wall, save for the little blocks beside the cactus to keep it from despawning. Oops, didn't mean to take a screenshot. But other than that, right here, you're seeing it all. So let's just hold control. Just start throwing everything in there. You know what? Let's even go in the inventory and just start dragging stuff out of the inventory. It may take a while because I didn't consider. Oh, jeez. I didn't consider they would get stuck above that. Then again, when are you ever gonna unload that much into it? So, it just keeps spamming the items onto that cactus, and eventually they will all be gone, so, shut up. Anyways, guys, here's what you are going to need to follow this tutorial. You will need one cactus, one of any type of sand. I used red sand because it stands out among all the other sand. Two observers, two blocks of choice, one dropper, one hopper, one comparator, one sticky piston, one minecart with a hopper in it, and whatever block you want your garbage can to be, or you can just put nothing there if you want to just have a random spot on the floor, and hey, drop your item here. But I'm using a cauldron because, in my opinion, it is what looks most like a garbage can. Of course, you're going to be digging the area, but I made a big area up here for display purposes, and it is the same dimensions, but as I said earlier, the whole redstone fits in this one area, but I dug out a much bigger area so you'll have space. So, obviously, I have this here, but what you're going to want to do is dig a pit that is 4 this way and 4 this way, and 5 blocks up and down. Alright, so come to any corner of it you want, as you see I already have, and that's where you place your sand, and right on top of it, you're going to place your cactus. If you want, you can straight up leave the blocks here, so that way it'll be 4 blocks there, but that just seemed too specific to mention, right? You see, there can be blocks under there, but they're not essential. So now that you have your cactus there, jeez, now we can see what it's at its normal state. So you're going to put one of your blocks of choice right here, up to the corner of the cactus, and you want to place your observer so that the red dot is facing outwards. So, come here and place it against the corner of that, and then here and place it like that. Oh, wait, no, okay, place one facing here. Okay. Hello, this is post-edit Wyclo. I put that observer facing the wrong way. Both faces are supposed to be towards each other, so make sure the red dots, see the arrows on top of the two observers? Make sure they're both pointed away from each other. Sorry about that. Then you're going to place your other block of choice right here. So you almost have like a checkered pattern made out of your choice blocks and your observers. Alright, now you're going to see this L shape right here. Nothing has to be here, like literally nothing has to be here. And right on top of this area, that is where your dropper will go, and that's the dropper that's going to be spamming all your items. Okay, so now right here is where you're going to want to put your comparator. And right here is where you're going to want your hopper. You're going to want to crouch place that so you don't go into the dropper, obviously. Now we are already almost done, so I'm going to place a block right here, grab any rail. I prefer to use powered rails because they make the minecart have a harder time moving. Place the minecart on top of it, and then break the block, and the rail, you'll see, goes straight onto the cactus, which is exactly what we want. Now take whatever block your floor or ground's made of where you're placing this, and get a normal piston. And using that piston, I didn't put a normal piston here, did I? Okay. Good. Using that piston, you're gonna push the block in here, so you're gonna push the block in here so that the minecart is flipped into the block and you can't see it. It's completely hidden, and that's also a great way to make a whole bunch of different hidden entrances. That's what I was trying to do with here. when I actually ended up discovering the garbage can trick, right? That's, I might do something with that. Anyways, now that you got your block clipped into place, break the piston and break whatever you powered it with, and then you can just fill in your area and then put whatever you want to be the garbage can. So like I said, I'm going to be using a cauldron, and here we have our cauldron, right? And this should be all the redstone done, so it literally just looks like some checkers, and if I did this all right, I should be able to throw this whole stack of dirt in there. I placed an observer the wrong way. Alright, there we go. The observer's faces have to both be towards the center. Both of this observer's face is towards the center. There we go. That was a bit of a rookie error. Alright. So now, as you can see, this observer facing this way. This observer facing this way. I literally got those both wrong. How did I get them both wrong? And now it's all working. So let me try that again, now that I actually know I have it right. Throw your stack of dirt in, and away it goes. It just gets absolutely spammed into that cactus. You can throw whatever you want in it, because cacti will even destroy netherite. You don't have to worry about that. It's not immune to it. Like, it's not immune to cacti like lava is. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and consider using this thing in some of your builds. If you have items that you just have no use for, of course, you could just throw it at a cactus or into lava like a normal person, or you could overcomplicate things like a cool kid. Anyways, I hope you check out more of my videos, and you have a great day. Bye.